to come and play?
Oh, I can't, Elmo. I have so much to do.
Wow! What's all this, Abby?
Oh, these are my fairy tale books. Yep, I'm going to study all about them so I can learn.
Wow, Abby. Well, Abby must really like fairy tales.
Oh, I do. After all, I'm a fairy in training. See?
Oh, yeah.
I'm hoping that one day when I'm big, I might even get my own fairy tale.
Really?
Yeah. I'm hoping that one day I can be in a great story and maybe even use my wand to do magic and save the day.
Wow!
That's why I gotta brush up on all these fairy tales.
So which fairy tales does Abby want to look at first?
Let me see. Excuse me. Okay, here's one my mommy just gave me. Alice and somebody.
Oh! No, it's not... Now, that book is called Alice in Wonderland. See, Alice in Wonderland is one of Elmo's favorite stories.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, could you read it to me, please?
Oh, Abby, Elmo can't read yet.
Me neither. Another reason I wish I was bigger.
But Elmo can tell Abby the story.
You can?
Yeah, sure. The pictures in the book will help Elmo remember how it goes.
Oh, great. Let's do it.
Okay.
Come on.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Once upon a time, there was a little girl named Alice.
Not Allison.
That's right. Oh, see? See, there she is.
Oh, I like her dress.
Yeah, pretty. One day, when someone was reading Alice a book, Alice started to get very, very sleepy.
Getting sleepy myself.
Then Alice saw a rabbit running past. Only it wasn't like a regular rabbit. He had clothes on and he could talk and everything.
For a moment there, I almost fell asleep. Elmo? Elmo? Your ears, your nose, your tail. You look just like a rabbit.
That's because I am a rabbit.
But how could this happen?
Anything can happen in a dream.
A dream? Well, I guess I did fall asleep and... Oh, I must be dreaming.
Oh, no. I'm late.
What? What are you waiting for?
Oh, I wonder how far this hole will go. Whee! Oh, my wand! Oh, yes, my whiskers! I'm gonna be late! Wait! I'm late! You got my wand! Please come back!
Oh! Where'd he go? The only other way is through that small door. And he couldn't have fit through there. Could he?
I wonder what's on the other side of this door. There's only one way to know for sure.
Oh, it's locked. So much for that. Whoa! Was this table here before? And look, I wonder what this key's for. Hey, it's just the right size for that small door. It works! I'm too big. If I had my magic wand, I could poof my way to the other side of that door. But without magic...
Whoa!
Now I know that bottle wasn't there before.
Huh? Oh, I wonder what this says.
Did you say drink me?
I said, will you please take your hand off my neck?
Oh. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right. That's better. I said, don't drink me.
Oh.
Just do what it says on the card. Rhyme, drink.
Why?
You'll see.
Okay. Now, what sounds like drink? Pink?
Huh?
Oh, sink? Whoa, that made me shrink. Look at me. I'm so small.
Yeah, but now you're just the right size for the door.
I can't fit. Oh, oops. It's locked again. I forgot. I need the key. The key. Oh, no. I left it on the table. Oh, and it's so high. My little wings are never going to get me up there.
Yeah.
Oh, what do I do?
Ask the cookie.
The cookie?
Uh-huh.
What cookie?
This cookie.
Hello. Can you help me get the key?
Oh, that's a piece of cake. Cookie. Just hold me in your hand and rhyme, eat.
That's a strange way of doing things, but okay. I'll give it a try. Let's see. What sounds like eat? Sweet?
Yeah.
Treat? Feet? Heat? Street? I grew, that's so neat.
Whoa. See? Now you're bigger.
Yeah, I always wanted to be big, but not this big. What'd I do wrong?
Well, you said too many rhymes.
You only need a few. Just rhyme drink again, but take it slow.
Yeah, rhyme only a little at a time.
Okay, I'll give it a try. More rhymes for drink. Link, sink, think.
Whoa, stop right there.
Yeah, see? You're back to your regular size.
Yeah, now I'll put you two in my pocket so I can get the key. Okay, I got the key. Now let's keep getting smaller so I can get through the door. Clink, blink, wink. Oh, perfect.
Could do it.
Well, I couldn't have done it without you two.
You better take us with you.
You might need us again.
Good idea. I wonder what's on the other side of this door. There's only one way to know for sure. The excitement is more than I can stand. It's a wonderland. Wow. Everything's so big. This is so magical.
1,604. 4,605.
Boy, I wonder where those voices are coming from.
4,606.
4,606.
4,607.
4,607.
Excuse me.
Oh, greetings.
Hello, Mr. Caterpillar.
Oh, please. I am the Caterpillar. And you know why they call me the Caterpillar? Because I love to count things.
Well, you are not the only one.
Who are you?
Oh, this is my friend and counting partner, Little Rose.
Oh, you can call me by my Spanish name, Rosita. Hola.
Hola. Wow. Wow, a flower that can talk.
Yes, and in one, two languages.
Sí, uno, dos.
Well, it's very nice to meet both of you.
Now that you know who we are, tell us, please, who are you?
Oh, I'm Abby. Abby Kadabi.
Ooh, I've never seen an Abby Kadabi flower before. Where are your petals?
But you're mistaken, my rosy little friend. She's not a flower.
No?
Look at her wings. She's a bug like me.
No, I'm not a bug or a flower. I'm a fairy.
You are? Oh, would you show us some magic?
I'd like to, but I lost my magic wand, and I can't do magic without it.
Oh, well, I'm glad you're here anyway, because now you can count with us.
Ah, yes, we were counting blades of grass. Now, where were we?
I'm not sure. Let's just start at the beginning again.
Ah, wonderful idea.
Yeah.
One.
Uno.
Two.
Dos.
Excuse me, but I really don't want to count right now.
You don't want to count?
Then what do you want to do?
Well, first I'd like to get bigger.
Bigger? Hmm? Why would you want to be bigger?
Yeah, being small is great.
Well, that's what my mommy always says, but you see,
it's true. There are so many little things you can count when you're small, like petals on a rose.
Or the feet on a caterpillar.
Or droplets of dew on a leaf.
If you were big, you might not even notice some of the little things in life.
Yes, being small can be wonderful. Oh, don't be in such a rush to get bigger.
Well, I think I know what you're trying to say, but I don't want to be very big. I just want to be back to my regular size, so I can find the rabbit and get my wand back.
Well, a fairy needs her wand.
I sure do. Time to grow, Cookie.
Okie dokie. Rhyme, eat. Slowly, remember?
Got it. Heat, meat, seat.
Whoa.
Perfect. Oh, it feels good to be back to my regular size.
That's your regular size?
Uh-huh.
Oh, my. You are one. One very big fairy.
I am?
See, from down here you look muy grande.
Yes.
Gee, I always thought I was pretty small. I guess the size you are kind of depends on your point of view, huh?
Yes.
Oh, there goes the rabbit with my wand. I gotta catch up with him. It was nice meeting you. Bye. Oh, rabbit.
Farewell.
Adios.
Nice girl. Big. No.
Muy
no,
grande. Little.
Oh, muy, yes.
Muy.
I ran away for the tea party, Mr. Rabbit.
Is that our whole scene, Tweedledum?
Well, we're not actually in this story, Tweedledee. That's a common misconception.
Oh.
I'm late for the tea party! Oh, what tea party? Mr. Rabbit! Mr. Whoa! Oh my, that tree came out of nowhere! Mr. Rabbit! Mr. Rabbit! Oh, I can't believe I lost him again!
Nom.
I wonder what that sound is.
Nom.
What am I looking at?
Maybe question should be, what's looking at you? Meow!
It's a cat! Hi, kitty. Where'd you come from?
Me from Cheshire. Yeah, that real place, you know.
Oh, so you're a Cheshire cat?
Cheshire boogie cat. Yeah, special breed. Very rare.
Well, would you please tell me where I can... Whoa! I wonder where you went.
Hi.
Whoa! Oh, there you are.
Yeah, pretty impressive, huh? Me bet you never met anyone who could disappear like that.
Well, actually, I can disappear.
Really? You from Cheshire, too?
No, I'm a fairy, see?
Then let me see you disappear.
Well, I can't right now because I don't have my magic wand.
Oh, sure. Yeah, no wand. Yeah. Oh, that must be reason.
It's not easy being a fairy without a wand alone in a strange place.
Yeah, this about strangest place me ever seen.
Yeah. Hey, I'm supposed to have tea someplace with Mr. Rabbit. I wonder if you know where he would go for a tea party.
In word, yes.
Wait. Where'd you go? Oh, please come back.
What are you yelling for? Me right here.
Oh, so you were going to tell me which way to go?
Yeah. Just follow the yellow brick road.
Huh?
Oh, wait a minute. That different story. Yeah, just go that way.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Yeah, don't mention it, lady. Yeah, now we got to get back to packed schedule of eating cookie. Ah, nom, 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 meow.
Goodbye. Boy. Sure is a good thing he didn't know you were in my pocket, Cookie.
You're telling me.
You say something about Cookie.
Who, me?
You thought me heard Cookie.
No. And besides, my mommy always told me never to listen to people's conversations when you are invisible.
Oh, me so sorry. Yeah. Me no listen anymore. Yeah, okay. Me going to go now.
All right.
Here me go.
Okay, bye.
Me going to go right now. Me gone.
I can still see your eyes.
Oops.
Yeah. I gotta get to that tea party. I need to get my wand back so I can disappear from this place and poof myself home. There's the rabbit. Mr. Rabbit, hello!
A customer! Mousy, wake up! We have a customer!
A customer? Oh, a customer!
Oh, hello there, and welcome to Mad Hatter's Hat Shop! I am your cute, furry, and highly fashionable hatter!
Oh, and I am the hatter helper! Squeak! Well, I'm Abby.
Tell me, Abby, what kind of hat can we get for you today?
Undecided,
eh? Well, perhaps you'd like to peruse our store, or take a look at our catalog.
Did somebody say cat?
Cat-a-log. Relax, Mousy.
She's not here for a hat. She's here for the tea party.
Oh, of course she is. Business has been slow, so we pass the time by having tea parties.
Time for tea.
Ooh, please, sit.
Oh, okay. Hey, is that mouse asleep again?
Oh, she is just taking a little cat nap.
Did somebody say cat?
Cat nap. Nap! Take it down a notch, Mousy!
There, Mousy.
Anyway, Mr. Rabbit, there is something I've been
trying
to... Would
you care for some tea?
Yes, I'll have a little tea. Anyway, what is that?
A little tea, just like you asked for.
I have a big tea, see? When you said tea party, I didn't think you meant the letter T.
And why not? T is a very important letter. It is the first letter in top hat.
And table.
Not ticking.
Actually, yes, I do believe T is the first letter in the word ticking. You hear the T sound? T. Ticking.
No, my watch is not ticking.
Boy, I think it's broken.
No wonder I've been late all day. I wonder what time it is.
Time to get a new watch.
This is the strangest tea party I've ever been to.
That's because you never had tea with a Mad Hatter before.
Well, there's something I don't understand. Why are you called the Mad Hatter? What are you so mad about?
Well, at the moment, this annoying hat. But I am not only mad, I am a hatter of many emotions. Mostly because of my hats.
Because of your hats?
Oh, yes. A hat can really change the way you feel. For example, this hat that I wear on my head is much too big for me. And every time that it falls, it makes me mad as I can be. This makes me so mad!
The fit is bad. It makes him mad. The hat you choose does matter. It can change your mood and your attitude. He's a mad, 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 mad hatter.
when I wear a different hat. Now, this was a hat that I loved to wear when I was just a little lad. But now you can see it is broken, and I am feeling oh so sad.
He did feel mad, but now he's sad. The hat you choose does matter. It can change your mood and your attitude. He's a sad, 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 sad hatter.
Now for my favorite hat, so hold on to your hats. Now if you please take a gander at this hat, it is made of mostly fruit. Wearing this makes me feel glad and a bit hungry to boot.
He did feel sad, but now he's glad. The hat you choose does matter. It can change your mood and your attitude. He's a glad, 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 glad hatter.
Try it and you will see. A hat can change your mood, or I will eat my hat. Delicious! Well, after a light snack, I could use something to drink. I wonder where I can get the cup of tea.
Good question.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
But, well, there's something that I've been wanting to say.
Go ahead.
Well, Mr. Rabbit, my magic wand accidentally fell in your pocket.
Really?
Yeah. You've been carrying around all afternoon without even knowing it.
Oh.
Yeah, so, could I have it back, please?
Well, sure.
Oh, of course. Finally.
Uh-oh.
What?
There's nothing in the pocket except
a hole.
My wand, it's gone?
Well, it must have fallen out in the woods.
Sorry.
But I need my wand. I need to get back home, and I can't do that without magic. I need to find it right now.
You need to calm down. Here, have some more tea.
Oh, the letter T isn't going to help me now.
Then eat something at least. A scone, perhaps, or a cookie.
Did somebody say cookie?
I did. Who's that?
It's the Cheshire Cat. Did somebody say cat?
Whatever you do,
this is too much. I gotta go look for my wand.
You could just save one.
Where is it? Where could my wand be? Let me see. The rabbit came this way, so I'll follow the path that way and... Which way could it be? Do I go this way or that way or maybe this way? I don't know.
Now, where could she be? Oh, there you are.
Oh, Mr. Rabbit, what are you doing here?
Well, I came to help you look for your wand.
You did?
Uh-huh.
Well, thank you.
What's the matter?
Well, I'm lost and I'm tired, and this is a strange place, and I don't want to be here anymore. If I had my magic wand, I could poof myself home, but... now I don't think that's ever gonna happen. I feel like I'm stuck in a fairy tale.
When my mommy read me fairy tales, never thought could happen to me. Now here I am in the middle of one, and it's not what I thought it would be. I'm wandering through this wonderland, wondering about the wonders I see. For a place that's so full of wonder, it's not so
just want my wand, and I just want to find my way home.
Oh, no, oh, no, I'm late.
Wait, your watch is broken, remember?
Oh, yeah. Oh, good thing I've got an extra watch.
Oh, no! Now I'm super late!
Well, late for what?
Well, for His Royal Majesty's croquet game! I'm late!
Wait, Mr. Rabbit!
His Royal Majesty?
Maybe he can help me find my way back home. Mr. Rabbit!
I'm late!
Mr. Rabbit!
Where'd he go?
It's a door in a tree. I wonder where it goes.
This couldn't be where His Royal Majesty lives. Can it? It's so messy.
Make way for His Royal Majesty! Make way!
Introducing the King of Cards, His Royal Majesty the Grouch of Hearts! Here he is!
Yes. It's rotten to be here! Bring the new royal scepter!
Bring the new royal scepter!
My wand! Oh.
Who said that?
I did, Your Majesty.
And just who are you?
I'm Abby Kadabby, and that's my wand.
No, it's not. It's mine. I found it in the woods, and finders keepers.
Well, isn't there any way I can get it back?
Well, can you play croquet?
I don't even know what croquet is.
Perfect.
Huh?
Then I challenge you to a croquet game. If you win, you get the wand. If I win, I keep it forever.
Don't do it. His Majesty always wins.
But I gotta try. It's the only way I can get my wand back. What do I do?
It's simple. You use one of these tacky lawn flamingos to hit the ball and try to make it go under the worms.
Under the worms?
That's right.
Oh, so that's how you play croquet?
No, this is how I play croquet. And if you don't like it, you don't have to play. Then I get to keep the wand.
No, I'll play.
Tell you what, I'll let you go first.
Okay. All right, here goes.
Go.
Hey, those worms, they moved. The ball was going towards them and then they just moved.
Aw, tough break, kid. Now it's my turn.
I love that guy!
Yay!
Game over. I win.
Wait, that's it? That's the whole game?
Well, it is if I say it is, and I say it is.
But that's not fair.
Who said anything about playing fair? Knock it off! Now, the wand is mine!
Well...
What?
Well, that wand belongs to Abby, and Your Majesty should give it back.
Hey, you can't talk to me that way. I'm the Grouch of Hearts, and she's nothing but a little fairy.
Hey! Well, I may be little, but that doesn't mean I'm nothing.
You're out of here. A rabbit, too. Royal underlings, show them both the way out.
isn't really the time for a snack. Just grab onto it and do what it says.
Rhyme 8.
Fleet. Oh, treat.
Sweet.
Great.
Wow.
Meat.
Heat.
Great.
Go.
Whoa. Well, who's the little ones now?
Yeah.
I guess it was time for the cards to shuffle off. Now, Your Royal Majesty.
Well, what do you want from me?
Just what belongs to me.
Take the wand. It's yours.
I guess having that wand just wasn't in the cards.
Oh. You said it.
So how do we get down from here?
Simple. Now, just hold on to this bottle and do what it says.
Oh, okay.
Rhyme, drink.
Clink. Stink.
Let me see. Mink.
Wait!
See, back to normal.
Yeah, boy, being big was fun.
Yeah, but you know what I realized?
What?
Well, that being little is pretty great, too. Hey, now, where's my wand?
Oh, there it is.
Oh, my wand.
Are you going to use it to magically get you back home?
Yes, I am. It was nice meeting you, Mr. Rabbit.
Yeah.
But I've had enough of this fairy tale, and it's time for me to go.
Oh, okay. Oh, goodbye, Abby.
Oh, goodbye. And thanks for everything. Okay, Juan, time to poof me back home. Poof! Poof! Poof!
What's wrong?
Poof! Oh, it's not working.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no, I think my wand is broken. Oh, now I'll never get back home. I'm stuck here forever.
Oh, wait a minute, Abby. Wait a minute. This is all just a dream, remember?
Oh, yeah. That's right, I'm dreaming.
So to get back home, all you have to do is wake up.
Hey. You're right. But how do I do that? I don't know how to wake myself up.
Well, I'll help you.
You will?
Well, sure. That's what friends are for.
Thank you, Mr. Rabbit.
Anytime. Ready?
Ready.
Wake up, Abby. Wake up. 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 Wake up, Abby.
Mr. Rabbit!
Huh? Well, who is Mr. Rabbit?
Oh, Elmo! Elmo, you're back to normal and... Oh, I'm on Sesame Street!
Abby was sleeping.
Yes, and I had the most amazing dream.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you were in it, and I was in it, and we had all these crazy adventures and wild things kept happening, and... Oh, it was just like a fairy tale.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Hey, Abby! Abby should get someone to write it down. That way, Abby could have her very own fairy tale, just like she always wanted.
Nah, I don't think so, Elmo.
No?
No. I can always be in a fairy tale when I'm bigger. There's no rush. For now, I kind of like being little.